Today, I have for you in Elden Ring a weapon with a unique skill. You can only find this skill on this weapon, and yes, I think there is a spell that has a skill similar with this, but not a weapon. Look how it is, it's just like, I don't know, not like a torch, but like a big, you know what, I don't even know how, that thing, it looks exactly like a helm that I have in this game, a part of this weapon, that head. And let me tell you, this thing is so powerful, so good, and so underrated, and also very hard to get. Because yeah, if you don't know my channel, and if you are here for the first time, I'm gonna show you in this video every single step of the way. Even though if you are a beginner and if you just started this game, I'm gonna explain step by step of how you can get this weapon. Probably you're not gonna take this weapon in the first hours of gameplay, but definitely when you're gonna go to the snow region, you want to have this thing. I tested this weapon in a lot of places with a lot of enemies, and every single time was wonderful. I just love it. I love a lot of weapons in this game, but this one, it has something pretty unique. That skill, the Surge of Fate, again, it's unique and you can find only in this weapon. It doesn't require a lot of FP points to use it. You can use one after each other very fast. The first time when you cast it is gonna take 1 or 2 seconds, so it's quite slow, but then you can just cast it all over again pretty fast, all over and all over again. But your first cast is gonna be quite slow. Okay, now those guys just got me, but when I have the chance to cast it, I'm untouchable. Just look what I did to those guys. Yeah, no chance. And those how do you call them, lava things or flame things that just come from the sky, they're gonna do extra damage. But your first damage when you cast it, as you can see, it's quite huge, and then you can just repeating you're just gonna do damage all over again. As I just told you, in this video I'm gonna show how we can get it. Look how fast I killed a giant, and this is not on fast forward, this is in real time. For me it was pretty fast, only with the skill. Only with the skill. Let me tell you something else. Before you start the journey, prepare yourself with 1 or 2 stone sword keys. Those are the sword, not, those are the small knife that looks like a sword. Pretty much every single one of you know about that stone sword key. If you don't know how to get them, I have a video on my channel how you can get those. You can buy them from merchant and so on. Okay, from the first step, you have to reach Liurnia of the Lakes. Right here at the Stoneveil Castle, you can just bypass it going on the right side, but I recommend you to defeat 2 great bosses until you reach the capital. Then use this ravine site of grace to go on the right side and then reach the Belum Church. After you just reach the Belum Church, you have to go to the Grand Lift of Dectus. Right here, you're gonna use the Dectus Medallion left and right. If you don't know how to get that, again, I have a video on my channel with every single thing. Then, just go ahead to the Altus Highway Junction, go around to the capital. This is the big capital. Then, just reach the Outer Wall Battleground, and then here you have to defeat a knight before you enter to the capital rampart. Then make your way to the Avenue Balcony from the capital rampart. It's gonna be right over here on the map. Keep going until you reach the West Capital Rampart. I have videos also with that of how you can reach those locations. And here you have to reach the Earth Tree Sanctuary. Right here you're gonna find and defeat Godfrey. It's a must. Then go to the Queen's Bedchamber, and now you're gonna have a big fight with a big boss, with the main boss in the game. Here at the Elden Throne, you have to defeat Morgoth. Then you're gonna get the Rolled Medallion, a very important item in the game. With that medallion, just go ahead to the Avenue Balcony, teleport there, because we're gonna start from this location to go to the snow region, to the Forbidden Lands. From the Avenue Balcony, make your way to the main road of the capital until you're gonna reach the Forbidden Lands. Then make your way to the Grand Lift of Rolled. And yes, I have to tell you something. From the Grand Lift of Rolled, go to the Zamor Ruins and make your way on that small or narrow path. There is a bridge. We have to reach this location, but it's not that easy to get there. Make your way to the, what is the name of this one, Ancient Snow Valley Ruins, and then to the Freezing Lake. Very important to reach that. No, this is not the one, this is the Freezing Lake. We're gonna get our horse, and I'm gonna show how we can get to the next location, because for some of you can be a little bit complicated. I told you, and I have to repeat that. Now just follow me, but I'm gonna explain something very fast. For some of the players, this is quite hard to get location, because I got some, I'm not sure if that was a hateful comment or just a bad one, or a mean one. Yeah, let's call it a mean comment. From someone who told me, bro, don't show us how to get there, because if you search for an item, we already know how to be to a certain location and so on. Let me explain for all. Not every single one is in know how to play this game, and I'm talking also with the beginners, and also with the players that are in the new game 100. Don't matter. I talk for everyone, because yes, if you know how to reach the snow region, obviously you can skip a part of this video. Usually I told you that, but you can just take it from the video that you can skip a part of this video to go to the location where the sword will be, to the cave where the sword will be, because in this case this sword, or not a sword, this weapon, it's gonna be into a catacomb. So don't bring me the mean comments, because I don't want to hear. I can take it, but not something that it's useless, because you have to understand that are some new players that don't have an idea of how it can be to the snow region, or even there is a snow region, they don't know. So that's why I'm talking for everyone. Okay, now let's move on, because we just got that out of the way. We have to reach another site of grace. You're gonna see a big chain right here, a frozen chain, this one, and at the end of this chain is gonna be another new grace site. Now, lost grace found, discovered. I'm in the new game plus, so that's why, yeah. The giant's grave post is this one, and now you have to follow me until we wanna go to the catacomb. And yes, that's one, it's a pretty important one, because I'm in the new game plus after 500 of hours of gameplay, and I never knew how to be there. So this will be, in the new game plus, I just learned how to be into that catacomb. Pretty interesting the way to go there. Like always, I will show you the map of where I got. This is the path, exactly right here. And now into that big building, there is a lift that's gonna go down. It's gonna go down, and we're gonna reach that catacomb that I was just telling you about. But the struggle is not over, because now we have to go to a certain location to do certain things if we want to reach that weapon. So again, just follow me. I also forgot the name of this catacomb, the giant mountain, giant grave. I always forget names in this game. The giant conquering hero grave is the name. Yeah. And now prepare 2 stone sword keys and just follow me. Be careful. First thing, go on the left. Here you're gonna see a lot of enemies, but if you don't like to, you don't have to stay to fight them. There is gonna be an invisible wall that you can just hit. It will unlock this path. Just jump right here on this balcony. You're gonna see 2 small goblins that those goblins are gonna follow you, but you don't want to have trouble with them. Okay, you're gonna see this fire. Be careful. Almost died there. Okay. And be careful, because after this location, there's gonna be an enemy right here, a very strong one. I didn't have the sword ready for this guy. Almost, again, almost died. I got lucky. Let's see what I've got. Okay, the fire blossom. And if you want to stop that thing to not firing anymore, you can just hit it. If you hit it once, it will stop shooting flames. That's it. Now, let's move on to those stairs. There will be another monk right here that you can just defeat or ignore, depends how fast you are. This is the one. For the purpose of making a video, I always want to clear my path. But again, you can just stay to... I'm not the best. Even though I made a ton of videos, over 800 by now, and I know everything in this game, with the fighting, I'm not the best. I'm always honest with you. I'm a medium player, but I don't struggle to do that. I struggle to find things and to enjoy the game. Now, here you're gonna use the two stone sword keys that we have. So I was lost one. Okay, two of them, I think I just used. And then at the end of this thing, you're gonna find the sword. Why I keep calling this a weapon? It's a weapon, not a sword. And those guys, they're gonna try to defeat you. The cranial vessel candle stand. Okay, this is a candle stand. Yes, I was just wondering what is this. Take it and just run away or make your way to the cave to see what secrets are there. Because if not, if you don't want to explore, just wait for my videos. I want to share with you a lot of things from that cave, and I'm gonna post a lot more videos from that cave with interesting items. Now, this is the unique skill. As you can see, it says right here on unique skill, the Surge of Fate. This thing is based on dexterity and strength and fate, mostly strength and fate. Those are the abilities that want to level up if you want to make yourself, you make this weapon even better. So this is my first test, where I always test my weapons. No chance. The first damage, as you can see, took all his life almost. And if you just gonna continuing with that skill, your enemies will just drop like flies. Trust me, this thing is so good. It's better when you have a pack of enemy, and if you have a lot of enemies in the same place, you're gonna do a lot of damage. Trust me, all you have to do is to try to make to take the first hit, the first skill, to use the first skill. That's it. If you're gonna use that, everything, then it will be perfect. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this weapon you don't have, and it's something new for you, because I always try to bring you new things in this game. Even though now we are it has some mounts from the day that has been released, but we are keep finding secrets on my channel here. Over 700 videos, I want to make it over 1000 in this game. So again, stay with me, because I have prepared for you a lot of nice items, nice location, nice bosses, and everything in this game. Love you all, see you soon. Press the notification bell, like, subscribe, share. Bye. Look how beautiful it looks. Just beautiful.